host, it's Jen, your Adult and Teen Services Coordinator here at MPL. We know that finding your next great read can be a challenge. So each week we'll release these short book talks to help introduce you to some of our new arrivals and great library reads. April 22nd is Earth Day, a global movement to diversify, educate, and activate, a call for greater protections of our planet. The first Earth Day was in 1970, and today has over 1 billion participants. You can link up to this year's virtual climate summit and live streams by visiting earthday.org. In this week's hashtag Teen Tuesday Book Talk, we're discussing young adult climate fiction. Each of these books presents readers with a worldview that has been affected by climate change or global warming. First up, The Marrow Thieves by Cherie Dimaline. In this award-winning novel by Cherie Dimaline, the world has been destroyed by global warming. But it hasn't just affected our environment. It's wreaked havoc on our minds, too. The indigenous people of North America are the only ones who still have the ability to dream. And consequently, they're being hunted for their bone marrow. Frenchie and his friends are struggling to survive. What they don't know is that one of them holds the secret to defeating the marrow thieves. Dimaline not only imagines what a future destroyed by global warming may look like, but she also uses this novel to explore the history of indigenous loss and resilience. Read this one now before its follow-up novel, Hunting by Stars, comes out this fall. Next up is Dry by Neil and Jared Schusterman. In Dry, this father and son co-writing duo imagine a world gripped by drought. The tap-out, as it's called, has been going on for a while, and everyone's lives have become an endless list of don'ts. Don't water the lawn, don't fill up your pool, and don't take long showers. Until one day, the tap runs dry. Now, Alyssa's suburban California neighborhood has turned into a war zone of desperation as families and neighbors turn against one another in the hunt for water. When Alyssa's parents don't return, her and her brother's lives are threatened, and Alyssa will have to make impossible choices to survive. Dry asks readers to consider what happens when something we take for granted is taken away, especially when we have the power to make changes before the problem escalates to catastrophic proportions. As a bonus, there's also some interesting parallels between the drought situation and our current reality mid-pandemic. And lastly, Trail of Lightning by Rebecca Roanhorse. In Roanhorse's first book in the Sixth World series, the world has been destroyed by a sudden rising of waters in a climate apocalypse. Dinata, the traditional homeland of the Navajo tribe, has been reborn, and magic, including monsters, have returned to the world. Maggie is a Dinata monster hunter and supernaturally gifted killer who has been enlisted to help a small town find a missing girl. Maggie reluctantly enlists the aid of Kai, an unconventional medicine man, and together they travel the res, unraveling clues from ancient legends, trading favors with tricksters, and battling dark witchcraft. Cli-fi and fantasy combine in this Hugo and Nebula award-nominated title. Please note that this title does contain significant violence and is shelved in our adult fiction section. However, it would be an appropriate read for mature YA readers. MPL wants to help everyone be more environmentally friendly. Join us for our tag-inspired DIY plastic food wrap alternative program this Wednesday, April 14th. Pick up a take-and-make kit to make a beeswax food wrap alternative and join us online for a live discussion on single-use plastics and what we can do to eliminate plastic waste. This program is for ages 12 to 18. Email jpiquette@midlandlibrary.com to register and reserve your kit today. The library is now open for curbside service. Visit our website for a full list of details, including our frequently asked questions. You can visit us online via our website using the Free Simcoe County Libraries app or by calling 705-526-4216 to place holds on any of the books that I've mentioned here or any in the library. That's it for this week's hashtag Teen Tuesday Book Talk. Take care and happy reading.